What's up mga Kap and welcome again to our When in Halifax KAPmunity. Ayan mga Kap, kumusta po kayo? So in this video, we will discuss about the 10 top in-demand jobs here in Canada. 10 top in-demand jobs dito sa Canada. So if you're ready, let's begin. So the first top in-demand job dito sa Canada are registered nurses. As I mentioned mga Kap, there is a huge demand for registered nurses. The reason why is that the most common reason for that mga Kap is number one, the retirement age. The baby boomers noon, na mga nurses noon, are now in the retirement age. So, sa industry ng healthcare professional, yung mga RN na mga baby boomers are now in retirement age. So, ibig sabihin na sa retirement age, and because of the population ng Canada ay napaka-konti, hindi yun masusuplayan agad-agad or hindi mapapalitan agad-agad. So there's a huge demand because number one, yung mga nurses dati ng baby boomers are now in the retirement. And the second reason is, since yung population are in the aging population mga Kap, there is a huge demand for registered nurses sa nursing home, sa mga hospital settings. So there is a huge demand for registered nurses. And the NOC for that is 3012. So, pag pinag-uusapan ano ang NOC mo as a registered nurse, your NOC is 3212. And the average median salary, ibig sabihin yung salary ng in an average all throughout Canada is around 37.60. So, if you're interested to know about how to be a nurse in Canada, subscribe to our channel. And the second top in-demand jobs dito sa Canada are truck drivers. So the reason why again, why there is an in-demand, again, aging population. And number one po tatanda ninyo, pag pinag-uusapan truck driver, because geographical speaking, ang Canada ay napakalaking bansa. And napakalaking land area. When we say land area, pwede mong i-travel province to province by land. So the means of transportation, pag-transport ng mga goods, produce, and other products is through land. Kaya kailangan ng mga truck drivers. For example, you want to travel or you want to transport your products, let's say potato from Nova Scotia to Toronto. You can do it by land. So that's why mataas po yung demand ng truck drivers. So yan. And the NOC for that is 7511, 7521, and 7452. And the average per hour rate is 21.67 per hour. And the third in-demand job is welder mga Kap. The reason why kung bakit there's an in-demand jobs for welder, kasi maraming new job growth. Lumalaki yung industry na kailangan ng mga welders. And the NOC for that is 7327 and the average salary for welder is 25 per hour, di ba? And the third in-demand job dito sa Canada ay occupational or physiotherapy assistant. So this is in-demand job. The reason why, again mga Kap, aging population and in-demand ito sa mga nursing home. Diba? So sabi nga dito, many of those Canadian want to enjoy healthy lifestyle for as long as possible. So dito yung mga occupational or physiotherapy, palagi natin ito nakikita sa mga nursing home and hospital settings. And the average per hour all throughout Canada is 23 per hour. Ayan. And of course, if you are a software designer or a web developer or a programmer, there is a demand for software engineer and designers. Sabi nga dito, and it says here that almost 21,000 jobs are expected to be created in a software engineer between 2017 to 2026. The average per hour is 43.27 per hour. Na mas mataas pa sa nurse, no? So, the next one is industrial electrician. So, electrician enjoy some of the best job skill trades. Industrial electricians in particular are in high demand. So their per hour is 33.19. And the next is the pharmacist. Again, mga kap, because of the aging population, ang daming kailangan ng mga gamot, ang daming nagdi-demand ng mga gamot. And of course, mga kap, take note that this is a free healthcare. So, mga tao halos pwedeng kumuha ng libreng gamot or maybe paid by the insurance. So, the bottom line is there's a demand for pharmacies kasi yung mga tao dito, number one, they can afford to get medications or prescriptions. The second is most of the aging population is also needed a medication for maintenance. So, kung imagine mo aging population, kailangan ng maintenance na medications like pang hypertension, etc., etc. Imagine mo kung majority of the population are in the aging population, yung mga matatanda na. So, imagine the demand for pharmacists. So, there's a big demand for pharmacists and it will continue to grow. Napakaganda ng salary per hour, that's 50.31. Pero gaano kaya kahirap maging pharmacist dito? So we will watch our channel, subscribe to our channel mga ka, because maybe this is our next topic. So the next is the heavy duty mechanics. Simply because Canada is growing. Kung lumalaki po siya, there's a lot of new constructions, developments, and maybe in the manufacturing. So there's a high demand for heavy duty mechanics. And their NOC is 7327 and their average salary per year, ito ha, per year is 70,000 per year. Hindi to per hour ha, per year. The next one is a business developing manager. So syempre, we all know that Canada is a growing economy. Maganda yung economy ng Canada. And of course, there's a business development in demand because most of the businesses, small, medium enterprises, they want to grow their business and they need a business development manager. So their NOC is 4163 and again, their yearly average salary is 85,000 per year. So always remember, the economy of Canada is growing and there's a businesses that they want to start up and they want to grow their business. They need a business development manager. The next is the HR manager. Siyempre, if there's an in-demand job, sino magpa-process ng job na yon? Siyempre, si HR manager. You can see, mga kap, that there is a demand for jobs. If there's a demand for jobs, sino magpa-process ng mga trabaho nito? Kundi si HR manager. So, you can see, mga kap, that HR manager is also in-demand po dito sa Canada. So, if you are interested to apply dito sa Canada as an HR manager, you have a big chance, mga kap. Your NOC, if you are an HR manager, is 0112 and your average per year income is 85,000 per year. Wow! Galing. So, 85,000 per year. So, and that's it, mga kap. So, that's the 10 in-demand jobs for 2020 and beyond. I'll post the link on the description below, all the resources that I got, para at least you can read and verify, or you can, so that you can check more information about this. I'm going to post the link, all the resources na pinagtagpi-tagpi ko to create this presentation. So anyway, mga kap, the 10 in-demand jobs, don't worry if your job is not listed on this video, mga kap. Ang dami pa po mga in-demand jobs na hindi nakalista dito. So if your job is not here, you don't need to worry. The first thing that you need to do is comment it below, anong industry ka, anong job mo, and let's see, gawa natin ng video. Malay mo, ikaw ang gawang kong special video to explain how to find job on this kind of industry. Anyway, that's it mga kap, and before we end this video, I would like to encourage you to click the subscribe button and on the notification that you will be notified once we have a live streaming, most especially every Saturday 11 a.m. because we have a Pinoy Canada Immigration Forum Q&A kasama ang ating licensed immigration consultant dito sa ating KAPmunity, walang iba si Miss Amelia Ajo. And of course, mga KAP, encourage you to join our group. It's Pinoy Canada Immigration Forum, and of course, our four different KAPmunity Facebook group. I'll put all the link on the description below. And of course, mga KAP, if you want to see us, my family, exploring the Nova Scotia, we have also a family vlog. Ang pangalan niya ay the KAP Family. So please support our family blog. I'll put the link on the description below. And of course, see you in the next video. Thank you, KAP. Bye.